Hey, hi everyone. Today we are going to solve one of the simple problem, and still this is one of the important problem we are going to solve. The question name is valid parenthesis. So what they are saying is we are having a string, yes, which consists of opening bracket, closing bracket, and all type of brackets like parenthesis, curly bracket, square bracket. And we have to make sure if input string is valid. What is the criteria for string should be valid? Open brackets must be closed by the same type of brackets. Okay, agar wo parenthesis hai, it should be closed by the closing parenthesis. Agar opening curly bracket hai, it should be closed by closing curly bracket. The same with the second criteria also. Open brackets must be closed in the correct order. So take this example. So we have an opening bracket, then closing bracket. So this is a valid string. So we have an opening bracket, then closing bracket, then opening square bracket, then opening closing, then closing bracket, then opening a curly bracket, then a closing curly bracket. So this is also true. In this case, we have a opening parenthesis, but a closing square bracket, which is not valid, which is not compatible. In this case, we should return false. So constraint is a 10 to the power 4. So just a hack, whenever you see the constraint is equal to 10 to the power 4, right? You can assume that we can solve this problem until the complexity of a n log n. Okay, let's try to understand how can we solve this problem on the pen and paper. So as we have gone through the question, let's start with examples. So this is the opening square bracket and closing square bracket. So this is a valid. This is a opening parenthesis, opening square bracket, closing square bracket, and closing parenthesis. And if you just underline the opening consecutive brackets and closing consecutive brackets, you can see the last opening bracket is matched with the first closing bracket. The second last opening bracket is matched with the second closing bracket. So in this case, we have a one data structure known as stack, which allows us to maintain the elements in the order of last in first outs. So basically the parenthesis into the string, right? So it is arranged into the like a last in first out order, which stack maintains. So we can reuse the stack for this. So whenever, suppose let's take this example. So whenever we are encountering the opening string, right, we will enter into the stack. So like this. And whenever we are at a closing a bracket, right, we will pick the top element, which is didn't caught any closing bracket until now, and we will match with the current closing bracket. So it will match with this. So when we are at this, so this element is gone. So we will match with this. So this element is also gone. Then we are at a last bracket. So in this case, we will match with this. So that's how it will work. So basically what we need to do is just iterate over the string. If there is an opening bracket, insert into the stack. And if there is a closing bracket, check if there is a top element is matching with the current character. If not, return false. So that's how we can solve this problem. So let's try to code this. So let's code the solution. As we have seen, we will be having a one function to check the valid pairs. So wherever pair we will take a first parameter as opening bracket, second parameter as a closing bracket, and we will compare those. Okay, let's write that function. So def is valid pair. I'm naming that function, which will take a opening bracket and closing bracket. We will just check return true if opening bracket equal to opening parenthesis and closing bracket equal to closing parenthesis, or copy the same but for the square bracket. Just replace this with a square bracket and a closing square bracket. and again replace the same with a curly braces. Okay, so the function is ready. Now let's create the stack, and we will iterate over the string. If it is opening bracket, we will insert into the stack. If it is a closing bracket, then there are two conditions. If a stack is empty, matlab we don't have a matching opening bracket, so return false. If a stack is not empty, take the top element and compare with the current closing bracket. If it is not valid, then return false. So for ch in yes, if character in the opening brackets, how can we check that? Just pass the list of opening brackets. Yeah, that is pretty straightforward. If it is the case, then just append into the stack. Yeah, appended. Else if stack is not empty, matlab this is a closing bracket and stack is not empty, we will just get the top element stack.pop, and we will check if it is not a valid pair. The top is a current opening bracket because we are inserting only opening brackets into the stack, and current character is a closing bracket. Then return false. Again, there is a else. If a stack is empty and we are at a closing bracket, then also return false because we don't have a opening bracket for that current closing bracket. And at last, if there are opening brackets into the stack, but we have iterated over all the string, so there is a no matches for the opening brackets into the stack, so then also return false. So ideally we should have a length of a stack is equal to 0, but there should not be any character into the string when a string is valid. So stack is equal to 0. So that's pretty straightforward. The time complexity will be linear O of n because we are visiting each character only once. And at last, the space complexity will be also linear, because in worst case, there are all opening brackets and we will be going to store all of them into the stack. So in the worst case, that will be O of n. So that is pretty straightforward. Let me write down here. Time complexity will be O of n, space complexity will be O of n. Let me run this. Yeah, it is working fine. ठीक है, चलो बाय.